sit tight, cause I'm gonna pay you.
Nah, I'm just kidding, I'm fucking around. I'm hook up some vegan spaghetti. We'll go over a quick list of ingredients, show you how I cook it, and show you how I get down. That's it.
First thing I do is chop up my garlic. I usually get the garlic from Costco, what is it called, the minced garlic or whatever. But since I don't have that, I'll just mince it myself. This is not crack rock here. I know it looks like crack, but this is garlic. I'm going to show you how it's done. This is my lovely assistant, Zhane Garcia. Say hi to the camera. All right. Mince the garlic. Peel 2 carrots. Next, cut up broccoli. Cut up bell peppers. This is red bell pepper, which is... We also use green bell pepper. Okay, get on that.
Me.
Alright, this is a squash or a zucchini, whatever you want to call it. First, you gotta cut off the end. Boom. Then you just peel it. Just like you peel a carrot or potato.
Do it at one time.
I don't like the chunks too big. The garlic, carrots, onions, broccoli, cauliflower, red bell pepper, green bell pepper, squash, zucchini, and peas. Is that about everything? Are we missing anything?
Yeah.
What are we missing? No. We're not missing nothing?
Mm-mm. I'm a close up, but don't just cut my hand off, okay?
I'm trying to cut my hand. Alright, so I steamed the carrots. Nah, steam the carrots.
I got it now.
Uh-huh. Alright. Steamer. Okay. Just crank it up. Then come over. Get my carrots. Drop the carrots in. And just steam them for a little bit. Probably about 5 minutes or so. And while I'm doing this, I'm gonna crack open my sauces. But since this is the Ghetto Garver, your boy's coming with the straight ragouts off the shelf. I get my spice ones ready. It's like, got the paprika jumping off, got the onion, black pepper, Italian seasoning, white pepper, good old Morton's. My Morton's all on my sneaker. That's from Dave Chappelle, y'all don't even know. Got the veggies here chilling. Got Nene eating the carrot. Say peace to the people. Yeah. And I got the carrots steaming. Okay, so it looks like my oil was, hot. So we're gonna go ahead and start dumping these ingredients. We're gonna start with this garlic. I love you. Now say, what do you want? No, get above her. I'm gonna knock you out, boy. That's the little bandit there. You see that? Snatching up all my goods before I could even get it in the stuff. But you know what? I'm so happy that my kids love vegetables. They eat vegetables like other kids eat chips. You know? So I'm really happy about that. Red bell peppers? Red bell peppers? Red bell peppers, green bell peppers, look like it is powerful, so it's going to give it a real good flavor. Yeah, you gotta crack it, man. You know how we do, straight from High Street. Now, if I was really cock diesel, I would make my own spaghetti sauce, but man, you know, just use a dash of salt. Being that it's so much salt already in the sauces, being that they're processed, not homemade sauces. Gang of pepper. You got this kind of pepper. Now I think the carrots are done. Oh yeah, see? Nice and soft now, so that I can add them into the mix. Finally, the peas and the squash. Now, I'm not a fan of mushrooms, but you could also add mushrooms to this.
I do not want mushrooms because I hate them.
Yeah. I mean, I don't hate them. So, particularly care for them. There are some mushrooms that I like.
But that's another video.
I'll show you how to make those, too. Ah, you know how we do. Get you a nice big quart pot or whatever this is called. You gotta dig. Put some water in it. Got some oil in the water so the... splash. Oops. So the noodles don't stick together. You know, so you just want to make sure that your noodles aren't sticking, because sauce is looking good. This is looking good. So there you have it, folks. Vegetarian, vegan, whatever, spaghetti. You know. So that's pretty much it. Thanks to my assistant, Zhane Garcia, who without her, I
couldn't have got it done. Check in tomorrow when we make it fajitas. That's how we do it. Cooking in the hood. Ghetto Garvin, I'm out. Peace.
Brother of five, doing whatever I had to do to survive. I'm not saying what I did was all right. Trying to break out of the ghetto was a day-to-day fight. Being down so long, getting up didn't cross my mind. But I knew there was a better way of life, and I was just trying to find. You don't know what you do till you put under pressure. Across 110th Street is a hell of a tester. Across 110th Street.